A very good morning to you out there. It's another rainy day in the city of Lagos, and I hope you're either in the comfort of your home or under some form of shelter as you join me today. This is Plus Sports on Plus TV Africa, where we bring you the best of analysis on everything happening in the world of sports. My name is Okoye Adebari, and yes, as you can see, I'll be riding solo today in the studio. But nevertheless, I've got a great package for you today, and it promises to be fantastic, as always. Today, we start off with speed, drifting and hydraulics as we dive into the world of motorsports with Formula One. Now, over the weekend, the 2020 Formula One season did get underway with the Austrian Grand Prix. Months of postponement and rescheduling of races due to the global pandemic, the 2020 Formula One season took off on the 5th of July with the Austrian Grand Prix. The major talking points from the event on Sunday was a collective kneel taken by the drivers and crew members before the start of the race, the penalties given to Lewis Hamilton, and the poll results, which saw Mercedes' Valtteri Bottas finish first, Ferrari's Charles Leclerc second, and McLaren's Lando Norris in the third place, while Lewis Hamilton finished fourth. I've got Formula One expert Soliu Adeyemo on standby to give us more insights on the start of the F1 season. Good morning, Soliu.
Hey, good morning, Okoyemi. How are you doing this morning?
Very well, thank you. Thank you for joining us on the show this morning.
You're welcome, bro.
All right, so first of all, it's very nice to have Formula One back. Now, how long did it take to get this season underway? We know that many races were actually postponed due to the ongoing pandemic, but definitely now we have a calendar and we did start this weekend. So what went into getting the Formula One season underway once again?
It took a lot. It took a lot of planning, a lot of thinking, a lot of thought processes that went into this year. Remember, we were supposed to have the first Grand Prix over 4 months ago, but because of the COVID-19 pandemic, we couldn't have it in Australia. In fact, the drivers and everyone, they were already gathered at Melbourne Park before this Grand Prix was called off altogether. And now here we are. I mean, the F1 community hasn't realized, I mean, what the effect of lack of races, what was going to be on the economy of the sports, and also some of the teams in particular. So they said there was a need for them to have a Grand Prix, to have the season at all. And now, what it means is that they look at the rules and it's clear that what they needed to have a championship was just a minimum of 8 races, and which is what has been set out now. So I think they are good to go, and the Austrian Grand Prix, the opener, I mean, is as if that we were never out of racing at all.
Mm. Yeah. All right, then. Now, taking a look at the Austrian Grand Prix, which did take place this weekend, I mean, the major talking points obviously has to be Lewis Hamilton. I mean, for the first time in about 3 calendar years, he finished outside the top 3. Now, let's take a look at his penalties and what happened. You know, going through, he managed to attract 3 penalties from the stewards, and even 4 penalties also after that. I mean, what went into that? Maybe was, would you say that he was not focused on the race because of the motion and him trying to fight for the Black Lives Matter? And also, in winter, he has had issues with some of his teammates. But I mean, attracting about 7 penalties in one day through different violations, what really happened with Lewis Hamilton?
I think for Lewis Hamilton, it's not about lack of concentration. I mean, it is all about that. That's what racing is all about. Weekend started from being spectacular to being disastrous, if you may, because I remember the opening practice sessions, that the first and the second one. I mean, team was blazing. I mean, the crash where he actually finished ahead of every other driver during the fourth and the second practice session. That was on Friday. I mean, good Friday it was for Hamilton, but it all started to unravel on Saturday, actually, during the qualifying, the third session of the qualifying, when Valtteri Bottas, Hamilton, Mercedes teammate, was when he was out of the track. And what the rule says is that, I mean, the drivers were expected, I mean, to drive, to slow down sufficiently on that yellow flag. You know, yellow flag is like a caution, I mean, for you to drive slowly and actually slow down sufficiently. But it was discovered that Hamilton did not slow down sufficiently. That was, by the way, after the protest by Red Bull. You know, Red Bull had Max Verstappen in third position after the qualifying. So Hamilton was penalized, was given about four place quick penalty. I mean, for that particular violation of not slowing down sufficiently. So that was what it is. He was dropped to 10th or thereabout on the grid. But again, Hamilton picked up his tire racing, good racing in hard. But something of the old occurrence happened again, which was a collision with Alexander Albon. If you remember, in November of last year at the Brazilian Grand Prix, Hamilton had similar collision with Alexander Albon. So Albon was put out of the race, but Hamilton was penalized in Brazil, same as what has happened again at the Austrian Grand Prix, where he was penalized. This time around, he was given 5 seconds time penalty. You know, 5 seconds in F1 is like 5 hours. It's like five hours. That's how bad it is. So Hamilton finished second behind the race winner, Valtteri Bottas. So 5 seconds means he dropped out of the podium finish, which promoted the third driver. That's talking about Ferrari, Charles Leclerc, and also McLaren. Young boy, the British young boy, Lando Norris, for his first ever F1 podium finish, for him and also for McLaren in a long time. So it was an exciting weekend. I mean, those were just few of the incidents. You know, it was an epic start to the 2020 F1 season. I mean, we talk about Hamilton Edic. We talk about the brilliance of the young boy, Lando Norris. And also, we talk about the total package of the racing that we had. In total, we have 3 safety car incidents. And also, we had TNS, that is driver that did not finish, not less than 6 of them. So, it was exciting. It was dramatic. I mean, it was as if we were never away from racing. And the drivers actually came up and they showed it is in them. I mean, to drive. For some teams, it's not what they expected. Especially for Ferrari, which is something I think that we need to talk about too.
Yeah. All right. Great. Now, just before I let you go, one last question. I need you to predict the final pole positions by the end of this 2020 F1 season.
Well, it's going to be tough for now, because I think the prediction before the teams started in Austria was that, yes, in terms of the pecking order, the teams were ahead. And so it is now. There's no question about that. But it's not just a question of who is going to take the lead between the two drivers, Hamilton or Valtteri Bottas. No, Valtteri Bottas has laid down the marker now. You know, he has had a good start, 25 points in the bag already for him. So what it is now that Hamilton has a brilliant task of doing better than his teammate, if he's going to win that record-breaking championship, and that starts this weekend still in Austria. So the next race this weekend is going to go a long way to give us a better idea of how the grid is going to shape up eventually at the end of this particular season. Because you have minimum races, okay. And what we think is that you need to hit the ground running as soon as possible. If you are caught up in the opening few races, then you're out of the picture to the end of the season. So, for now, I want to keep Mercedes. I'm not even going to put Ferrari in the second position. Okay. I'm going to put Red Bull in the second, and maybe Ferrari in third position. Because that's how it is. But in terms of driver, I'm still going to be sticking out my neck for the Amir team to claim that record-breaking championship victory for him this season.
All right, great. Thank you so much, Soliu, for your insights this morning. Do remain safe.
You're welcome, Ollie.